It was like a mini bulldozer. I couldn't believe it.
When we first visited Fred and Sherry LaVale at their home, they showed us the damage wild pigs had caused in their South Irving neighborhood. More than 3 months later,
we haven't seen them.
Yeah. I think the proactive nature of the city and everything that they've done has sort of cut them off of the past.
I had no idea that we'd be that successful at it.
The city of Irving's success at controlling the wild pig population is getting the attention of the state.
I'm very excited about what Irving is doing to help control our feral hog problem.
Texas Agriculture Commissioner Todd Staples visited a trapping site near the Trinity River where more than 200 feral hogs have been caught. Several wild boars captured here have weighed more than 300 pounds. They dig up grass and crops looking for food. Farmers across the state have been hit especially hard.
No one has done a solid head count of these feral hogs. However, the best estimate that we have is over 2 million. We know that they reproduce at a very rapid rate, and so we need everyone, landowners, cities, nonprofit organizations, everyone working together to impact the problem.
People have stepped up and really made a difference and really done a lot. It's an issue that I didn't realize how much was going on until you talk to the different areas of the community where they're in their homes or their backyards, and they're all the way from the Graff Farm to the Texas Stadium site. They're along their areas, so they're catching them all over the community.
The problem has elevated.
Pigs that are calm one moment can quickly get agitated. As the number of wild hogs increases, they are moving further into cities.
Hogs are smart animals. That's why it takes a lot of effort to, they're not pretty and they don't smell good, but there's nothing to do with their ability to get out of traps. And so Irving is sharing this information because the more people that understand the problem, the more we can do about it.
The agriculture commissioner is calling on other cities to follow Irving's example in controlling the pig population.
I think Irving is a model. Irving is setting high standards. They're being very aggressive in this, and I appreciate their leadership for Texas.
I've had Farmers Branch and Dallas and different communities approach and ask what we're doing.
Irving traps the animals, then sells them to a processing plant in Fort Worth.
You can't turn them loose in another portion of the state because they'll only add to the problem, and it only makes it worse. So there are markets that are established for these. I think that's a good use.
Money raised is donated to the Animal Assistance Fund to help more adoptable dogs and cats at the Animal Care Campus find homes.
We've made a conscious effort to be respectful for the animals in the community, and I think this is playing out right here today.
Trapping efforts are slowing down for the summer months, but Animal Services knows there is still more to do.
It's going to be part of my world for a long time.
We're finally going to start looking at trying to finish up restoring the yard.
The LaVales are moving forward, but the wild hogs are never too far from their minds.
When I go to a barbecue place now, I say, "Where did your pork come from?"
They have a sense of humor about their encounters with the pigs, especially since the city has removed so many of them.
I can't compliment enough.